In this video, we will continue our discussion of airway hyperresponsiveness and airway remodeling by discussing two emerging treatments that are currently being researched by the Firestone Institute. Traditionally, inhaled corticosteroids are effective in most patients and are the most common way that asthma is managed. However, 5 to 10% of people with asthma cannot manage their symptoms with inhaled corticosteroids, meaning there's a need for other treatments. Before we talk about these other treatments, make sure that you watched our video where we discuss how airway remodeling occurs. Now, let's discuss a little extra background information about this mechanism.
As mentioned, despite having guidelines and recommendations for management and therapy, there are still many patients who continue to report that they cannot control their asthma. These patients have a decreased quality of life, worsening symptoms, increased use of medications such as corticosteroids, and emergency room or intensive care unit admission. In these patients, there has been strong evidence that using T helper 2 cytokines such as interleukin 4, 5, and 13 stimulates the eosinophilic and allergic inflammatory pathways. We discussed what cytokines are in our overview video. Interleukin 13 and interleukin 4 are created by white blood cells related to T helper 2 that are traditionally associated with atopy and allergic diseases, but can also be involved in pregnancy, fetal development, breast development, lactation, carious neuronal functions including cognitive and learning processes, and memory formation. Atopy is the tendency to develop an immune response against an array of antigens and allergens, such as asthma. Every cell in the body has the potential to respond to interleukin 13 and interleukin 4. They may respond to one of these interleukins or both, but this depends on the cell. Once the body interacts with allergens, surface-level lung cells, known as pulmonary epithelial cells, produce some interleukins, leading mast cells to produce interleukin 13. T helper 2 cells and basophils will produce interleukin 4. Interleukin 13 creates a chain reaction that increases the cell count of goblet cells, smooth muscle cells in the airway, and fibroblasts, which are connective tissue cells in the body. Interleukin 13 also induces the polarization of macrophages, in which macrophages, a type of blood cell in the immune system, differentiates into specific roles depending on the environments that they are in. They differentiate into two types, known as M1 and M2 cells. Interleukin 4 will go on to activate macrophages, eosinophils, and induce the IgE synthesis from B lymphocytes and plasma cells. Together, interleukin 13 and 4 are responsible for producing the symptoms of asthma, potentially leading to airway hyperresponsiveness in patients. For example, interleukin 13 is responsible for mucus overproduction and airway remodeling, while interleukin 4 is responsible for stimulating IgE production. Interleukin 5, another type of cytokine, is responsible for the differentiation, survival, and degranulation of eosinophils.
Monoclonal antibody therapy is a promising treatment for airway hyperresponsiveness. A monoclonal antibody is a lab-made antibody that comes from a population of cells which only contain one cell type, hence the prefix mono. Monoclonal antibodies are made in the lab from white blood cells, which are the cells that naturally produce antibodies. There are two up-and-coming monoclonal antibody treatments that we'll discuss in this video, Dupilumab and Anti-IL-5. Both of these treatments are being researched by the Firestone Institute. Let's start with Dupilumab. Dupilumab is a monoclonal antibody which research has shown to be effective in treating airway hyperresponsiveness in severe asthma cases. As mentioned, interleukin 4 and interleukin 13 are two of the cytokines involved in causing inflammation during the IgE-mediated asthma pathway. To understand how dupilumab works, we must first explain the details of how the interleukin 13 and interleukin 14 receptors work. There are two types of receptors for these cytokines, type 1 and type 2. The type 1 receptor consists of an interleukin 4 alpha and a gamma C subunit. Interleukin 4 binds to the alpha subunit to exert its effects. The type 2 receptor can bind both interleukin 13 on the interleukin 13 alpha subunit and interleukin 4 on the interleukin 4 alpha subunit. Dupilumab is a dual receptor antagonist, meaning it can bind to and block the interleukin 4 alpha subunit of both the type 1 and type 2 receptors. So, not only does this prevent interleukin 4 from binding, but it also prevents interleukin 13 from binding to its receptor as well. This, in turn, stops interleukin 13 and interleukin 14 from performing their regular functions, thus preventing airway hyperresponsiveness and airway remodeling. Dupilumab research is still underway, but it is typically administered by an injection under the skin.
Interleukin 5 is the main cytokine involved in the activity and survival of eosinophils. These are a type of white blood cells and a major component of the immune system that cause airway inflammation, a characteristic of asthma. Monoclonal antibodies targeting interleukin 5 or its receptor are effective at reducing asthma severity. Moreover, studies have shown that anti-interleukin 5 treatments can be used in addition to standard care in patients with severe eosinophilic asthma. There are currently three FDA-approved anti-interleukin 5 treatments: benralizumab, mepolizumab, and reslizumab. Mepolizumab and reslizumab bind to interleukin 5 and disrupts its binding to the receptor on eosinophils and basophils. Benralizumab binds to the alpha chain of the receptor and inhibits its activation while also inducing programmed cell death in eosinophils and basophils. And as a result, anti-interleukin 5 treatments can effectively alleviate airway hyperresponsiveness. In this video, with the help of Dr. Bowdish from the Firestone Institute, we discuss two cutting-edge treatments for airway hyperresponsiveness, dupilumab and anti-interleukin 5. These treatments consist of monoclonal antibodies that target eosinophilic and allergic inflammatory pathways. Thank you for listening.